Welcome back to Theology of the Body on the go in the floating Camry classroom of Bill Donahue, where I give you a little 5-minute blast of this beautiful teaching of Pope John Paul II. It's dangerous, but such is life. All right. When we last left our topic, we were talking about the phases in the human drama, according to John Paul II and his teaching, Theology of the Body. We talked about how he's trying to answer the questions, what does it mean to be human? And how can I be truly happy? Questions of identity and vocation. We talked about how in the identity question, who am I? What is the adequate anthropology that will give us a total vision of man? We said that we have an origin, a history, and a destiny. So let's just talk about our origin a little bit. For John Paul II, obviously, this begins in the book of Genesis. That's correct. Genesis means origin. So John Paul spends loads of time dwelling on, meditating on, unpacking some of the most simplistic, seemingly simplistic, verses in the book of Genesis that perhaps many of us just gloss over. Verses like, "And the man and the woman were both naked and felt no shame." For John Paul II, this is annoying. For John Paul II, there's such a depth to that one line, Genesis 2:28, I believe, "The man and the woman were both naked yet felt no shame," that he'll spend pages on it. So, let's spend a couple of minutes on it at least. "In the beginning, God made us good. Behold, it is very good," God said in Genesis, after creating man and woman. So, why were we so good? Well, because God took matter, which he created out of nothing, and breathed his life into it. So suddenly, we became matter flooded with spirit. A physical element married to a spiritual element. And this, again, sets the human person a quantum leap above the animal species, right? We were created on the same day as the animals, day 6 in Genesis. But with that breath of life, that spirit in our origin, we are worlds above the animals that also fill this world with us. We are, again, a marriage of body and spirit. So in the beginning, when male and female gaze upon each other, they're naked without shame, because they see this marriage. They see that the body, as John Paul says, is the transparent expression of the person. What a beautiful phrase. The body of Adam and the body of Eve were a transparent expression of the person. And John Paul says that they looked upon each other, they gazed upon each other with all the peace of the interior gaze. Now, that should fill our hearts with a kind of a longing, you know, like a breeze from the sea that kind of stirs up memories. All of us long to have this look from others upon our hearts, to see us fully as we are. And we gaze, too, to penetrate and to see the other fully for who they are. We all long for this transparent gaze, right? A couple years ago, our government was talking about being transparent, right? More transparency. I don't know if we succeeded in that, but anyway, it's a whole other question or topic. Now, this origin, this beginning, with this beautiful interior gaze that sees both person, person as body before me objectively, and soul, a subjective reality, a subject of holiness, we mean, this great gift has within it three other experiences, right? This original innocence that we were created in. And we'll have to spend time next time dwelling on those. So in the phase of original man, original humanity, we have an experience, again, of original solitude, original unity, and original nakedness. We've already hinted at the original nakedness a little bit, but we'll unpack that a little bit further. On a final note, for this little 5-minute shot, TOB on the go, original man, this reflection, is beautiful on a whole other level because We don't begin our story with original sin. Right? We don't start on a pessimistic sort of a note. John Paul takes us deeper back into our history. We didn't begin with sin. We're not corrupt beings in that sense. Before original sin, there was original innocence. And as I hinted at, original solitude, this other experience, a call for original unity and original nakedness, which John Paul says is the key for understanding God's plan for man and woman. So we'll spend some more time unpacking this first phase in the human drama because it's so important. We get locked down in original sin, but again, prior to that was something more beautiful. All right, thanks for tuning in. I hope that this is helping and making sense. And trust me, I'm safe. Got my seatbelt on, scatter vision, checking my mirrors. All shall be well. See you next time.